Today we are going to discuss wood ultrastructure and chemistry. Wood ultrastructure and chemistry. Now if you consider macrostructure, macrostructure, microstructure and ultrastructure. Macrostructure refers to the structure visible under the naked eye. Macrostructure referred to structure visible under naked eye. What can you see under naked eye? In the naked eye, you can see growth rings, sometime early wood, late wood, knots. Those can be seen under macrostructure. Gross feature, grain, texture, all these things are visible under naked eye. Without any microscope, you can see these are called macrostructure. Then after the macrostructure, microstructure. Microstructure is a structure visible under light microscope. Microstructure is a structure visible under light microscope. In the wood anatomy, we discussed about the microstructure where you can see the wood cells, vessels, tracheids, rays, parenchyma. So those wood cells can be seen under microstructure under light microscope. Normally under microscopy, microstructure, we measure the units in micrometers. Measure the units in micrometers. 1 micrometer is about 10 to the power of minus 3 millimeters. So in microscopy, we measure in micrometers. Then third one is ultrastructure. Ultrastructure is structure visible under electron microscope. Structure visible only under electron microscope is called ultrastructure. So there we get a nanometer. 1 nanometer is about 10 to the power of minus 6 millimeters. This one is 10 to the power of minus 6 meters. This is 10 to the power of minus 9 meters, nanometers. Under ultrastructure, now this is called nanotechnology. You must have heard nanotechnology, where the nano objects are visible under nanotechnology. Now, how do you understand nanotechnology? Now, for example, if you see an aeroplane, maybe about very long. Now, we are going to manufacture ultra aeroplane, very small one, then which can be, you can send that one through that door and you can use this as a spy camera. So this is nano scale. Nano scale is this one. Under the nanometer, under the ultrastructure, we can see cell wall structure. Cell wall structure, that means cell wall is made up of cell wall layers. Those cell wall layers, and also these cell walls are made up of what is called microfibrils. So, cell wall structure and microfibrils are visible under ultrastructure. Cells are made up of cell wall and lumen. Cells are made up of cell wall and lumen. This cell wall is made up of cell wall layers. Cell wall is made up of cell wall layers. Cell wall layers are made up of what is called lamellae. These lamellae are made up of what are called microfibrils. We'll discuss later. Microfibrils are the smallest structural unit. Microfibrils are the smallest structural unit that is visible under electron microscope. Smallest structural unit visible under electron microscope is called, these are called microfibrils. So cell wall is made up of cell wall layers, and those are made up of lamellae and microfibrils. Cell wall is made up of three cell wall layers: middle lamella, primary wall. Cell wall is made up of middle lamella, primary wall, and secondary wall. Secondary wall consists of three layers: S1, S2, and S3. Middle lamella, primary wall, and secondary wall. The secondary wall is made up of three layers: S1, S2, and S3. S1, S2 is the thickest layer, and S3. S2 layer is the thickest cell wall layer. S2 layer is the thickest cell wall layer. So we show here wood is made up of wood cells. Wood cells are made up of cell wall. Cell wall is made up of cell wall polymers, three cell wall polymers, which we will discuss in a moment. What are the three major cell wall polymers? Major cell wall polymer is cellulose. Other one is hemicellulose and lignin. Here the cellulose and hemicellulose are what? We have major macromolecules, no, carbohydrate, lipid, protein. These are carbohydrates. Cellulose and hemicellulose are carbohydrates, but lignin is not a carbohydrate. It is a complex biopolymer. So mainly these cell walls are made up of cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin. So these are the cell wall layer. Center of the cell wall, we have a middle lamella. Then either side of the middle lamella, there's a primary wall. Then S1, S2, and S3 layers. Middle lamella and primary wall are collectively known as combined middle lamella, CML. Middle lamella and primary wall are collectively known as CML or combined middle lamella. As I said, here, S2 layer is the thickest layer. Therefore, most properties, most important wood cell wall is S2 layer. Most wood properties depend on the structure and composition of the S2 layer. Many wood properties depend on the S2 layer. So this again shows the different cell wall layers: mid lamella, primary wall, S1, S2. You can see the thickest layer is S2, and innermost one is S3 layers. Then we said the cell wall is made up of cell wall layers. These are the cell wall layers. These are made up of lamellae and microfibrils. Now the microfibrils are the smallest structural unit that is visible under electron microscope. Smallest structural unit visible under electron microscope are called microfibrils. Microfibrils are mainly made up of cellulose. But it also contains hemicellulose and pectin, hemicellulose and lignin. It also contains hemicellulose, which is a polysaccharide, and lignin. This is a little bit of wood chemistry. So wood is made up of cell wall polymers. It is made up of hemicellulose, lignin, and extractives. We'll discuss first about the cellulose. Cellulose is made up of beta D glucose. This is a glucose molecule. There's alpha glucose and beta glucose. This is beta D glucose. Cellulose, this is glucose. So cellulose is made up of this type of beta D glucose. These are linked by what is known as glycosidic bonds. Glycosidic bonds, normally called 1,4 glycosidic bonds, COC bonds or glycosidic bonds. Then the resulting molecule is long unbranched molecule. Cellulose is long unbranched molecule, therefore it is very strong molecule. Cellulose is long unbranched molecule, therefore it is very strong. These cellulose chains, linear cellulose chains are linked by hydrogen bonds. These are linked by hydrogen bonds. These long cellulose chains are linked by hydrogen bonds. So, all cellulose molecules are parallelly arranged. This parallel arrangement of cellulose chains are called crystalline arrangement of cellulose chains. We call cellulose is a crystalline molecule. Cellulose is a crystalline molecule because these cellulose chains are parallelly arranged. However, between two set of cellulose chains, this is one set of cellulose chains, between two sets of cellulose chains, there are some non-parallel regions. Between two sets of cellulose chains, there are non-parallel regions. These are called non-crystalline region or amorphous region. Between two crystalline regions, there are non-crystalline or amorphous regions. So, this is the arrangement of cellulose chains. This cellulose is long unbranched molecule. Glucose molecules are bound by COC glycosidic bonds. Then these form microfibrils. So, cell wall is made up of this type of microfibrils. So, cellulose molecules are crystalline region and also non-crystalline or amorphous regions shown here. Crystalline region is a parallel region and also non-crystalline or amorphous region. Which region is very strong? Crystalline region or amorphous region? Crystalline region. Crystalline region is very strong. Crystalline region depends on the length of the cellulose chains. These are very long molecules. These are arranged parallelly in the microfibril, in the fibers or the trachees. These cellulose chains are parallelly arranged. Therefore, cellulose is a strong molecule. However, the weak regions are those amorphous regions. So, the core of the microfibril are made up of these cellulose chains. So, this is the core of the microfibril, is made up of cellulose chains. This is the cross section, is made up of cellulose and crystalline cellulose chains. That is cellulose. Then the second molecule is hemicellulose. Unlike cellulose, hemicellulose is shorter molecule. Hemicellulose is shorter molecule. It is branched, shorter, and it is branched. Therefore, relatively weak compared to cellulose. Hemicellulose is relatively weak because it is branched and shorter. There is only one cellulose. There is only one cellulose. However, there are several hemicellulose types depending on the monomer. Always cellulose is made up of one monomer, that is beta D glucose. However, hemicellulose is made up of several types of monomers. So, depending on the monomer type, there are different types of hemicelluloses. Softwood and hardwoods have different hemicellulose types. Softwood hemicellulose and hardwood hemicellulose are different. So, these are the differences in hemicelluloses in softwoods and hardwoods. Softwoods have what is called galactoglucomannan. Major hemicellulose type in softwood timber is called galactoglucomannan. However, major hardwood hemicellulose type is called glucuronosilane. So, these are the different types of monomers and the differences between cellulose, different hemicellulose types. As you can see, Chemically, chemically wood is different from one species to another species, even from softwoods to hardwoods, depending on the hemicellulose type, these wood are different. So, the normally the hemicellulose chains are located around the cellulose core. This is cellulose. Around the cellulose, hemicellulose are located. Then the lignin. Lignin is not a carbohydrate. It is a complex biopolymer. It's not a carbohydrate, it's a complex biopolymer. It is branched and is shorter chain. It has shorter chains. It is also branched and it has shorter chains. That is there. That means lignin is anyway amorphous, not crystalline, is amorphous. This is the lignin structure. This is lignin monomer, repeating unit of lignin. And lignin has this kind of complex structure. Repeating unit is shown here. So, normally wood consists of cellulose, about 50% of cellulose, and hemicellulose about 30%, and lignin about 10 to 15%. So, major component is cellulose, then the hemicellulose and lignin. So, then the structure of the microfibrils. We said the three major elements, cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin. Core of the microfibril is made up of cellulose. Core of the microfibril is made up of cellulose, long chains. It is surrounded by shorter hemicellulose and lignin. So, this hemicellulose is there, then the lignin. This is hemicellulose and this is lignin. If you take a cross section, cellulose are arranged like this. Cellulose molecules are like sheets. Cellulose core is like sheets. They are arranged alternative to each other. These are cellulose. Around cellulose, there are hemicellulose. Outside the hemicellulose, lignin is located. Cellulose core, which is surrounded by hemicellulose and lignin. Cellulose core, hemicellulose and lignin. We call this model is like bundle of drinking straws. This arrangement is like bundle of drinking straws, like this. Bundle of drinking straws. Where the cellulose molecules, cellulose which is a very strong molecule, these are bound by, central cellulose chains are bound by hemicellulose and lignin. Central cellulose chains are bound by hemicellulose and lignin. Central cellulose chains are bound by hemicellulose and lignin. That is a bundle of drinking straw model. These drinking straws are cellulose chains. Drinking straws are cellulose chains. These are bound by they are pasted by hemicellulose and lignin. In between these cellulose and hemicellulose, in between the cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin are located. Here in this arrangement, cellulose gives the strength. cellulose gives strain. Cellulose is a strong molecule, crystalline molecule gives a strain. And hemicellulose and lignin gives elasticity and toughness. Elasticity is flexibility. Toughness is less brittle. Normally, any material has three structural properties. That is strength, flexibility, elasticity, and toughness. Structural material has three properties, which are contrasting properties. Some people think these are similar, but these are three different properties. One is strength. Other one is elasticity. Third one is toughness. Many of you know about the strength. Strength is ability to sustain a load or maximum load it can withstand. Strength is the maximum load it can withstand or load needed to break a material. No, load needed to break a material is called strength. This is measured normally on modulus of rupture. Modulus of rupture, which is measured in newtons per square meter. Newtons per square millimeter. Newtons per square millimeter. Normally, modulus of rupture is broken, measured when the material is broken. If you compare these two materials, this is weak, not strong. Even I can break. This is not as weak as that one. This is somewhat strong, but still you can break this one also. Likewise, you can try with different materials whether these are strong or weak. Now, the biscuit is weak. Second one is elasticity. Elasticity is the ability to return to the original shape, once the stress is released. This is somewhat elastic. Ability to return to the original shape. It will come to the original shape. Likewise, some materials are elastic. Some materials are not elastic at all. Now, this one is not elastic. Once it's broken, it's gone. This may be somewhat elastic. This is measured in what is called modulus of elasticity. Modulus of elasticity. Or in grade 2 science, or in advanced level, Young's modulus. This is also measured in newtons per square millimeter. In order to measure the elasticity, in order to measure the strength, you have to be destructive. But in order to measure the elasticity, these can be non-destructive. These are some materials. Some materials are strong and flexible. Some materials are strong but not flexible. Now, for example, there are different materials. Some polymers, elastic but not strong. Likewise, there are different materials, steel, very strong but not flexible. There is a stress strain curve. When you in advanced level, you must have done this kind of experiment. There is a rubber band is there. You apply a force. This is called stress. Once you apply stress, you get a strain. This is stress, this is strain. Or sometimes you call this is load. This is deflection. Load and deflection. So the curve here is deflection and the load, or strain and the stress. until certain point, this curve is like this. Stress is proportional to strain. Stress is proportional to strain. This is called elastic limit. Then after this time, breakage breaks. This is the break. Now the load of stress here is MOR. This is modulus of rupture. That is the force needed to break a material is modulus of rupture. This is modulus of rupture. And the tangent of this curve is modulus of elasticity. This tangent of this curve is modulus of elasticity. Up to this point called limit of proportionality. So this is the maximum load. This is the very famous load deflection curve or stress strain curve. Load deflection or stress strain curve. Normally, material can be loaded in three ways. In engineering, any material can be loaded in three ways. Compression, now in this when you are sitting, you are compressed on this disc. However, we will say not only compress, you get all these strains also. Other one is tension, tensile strain. Compression, tension is a pulling one. And other one is shear. If you have a sponge, put water into the sponge and you can try all these things. Compression, tension, and once you squeeze, that is shear. Any material has these three forces: compression, tension, and shear. When you are sitting, this is called cantilever method. When you are sitting on this kind of beam, this is called 3-point bending. Now you are sitting here. Top part is under compression. This part is under tension. This is under compression and this part is under tension. This is both compression and tension. Both compression and tension. This is called 3-point bending. 3-point bending is a common way of bending. In many beams are 3-point bending. It's combination of compression and tension. The first one is strength. Second one is elasticity. Third one is toughness. You can understand toughness by less brittle. Toughness is less brittle. That is ability to stay in one piece once the ability to stay in the in one place with load. Some materials are stiff. In fact, toughness is other side of the brittle. If the material is brittle, then the less tough. If the material is less brittle, then that is tough. It also can be known as ability of a material to absorb energy and plasticity deform without fractures, without fractures. One definition of a material toughness is the amount of energy per unit volume that a material can absorb before rupturing. So, ability to resist rupturing is the toughness. Now, this material is tough, that means it will not break into pieces. Likewise, you can try different materials whether they are tough or not. Like a mobile phone, you can this material is maybe this is foreign chalk, not brittle. This is tough because this is imported chalk. Likewise, you can this is tough. However, you can try with a glass bottle, which is brittle. Many synthetic materials such as these plastics, as you know that mobile phone covering is also plastic, but it look like metal. Some are cheap looking like this kind of plastic. Some mobile phones have very pleasing atmosphere. It is very smooth, with user friendly. It ranges from Chinese phones to USA's Apple iPhone. Different materials have different qualities. One of the very difficult property to achieve the plastic is toughness. So, in this graph also shows some materials are tough. This is a graph between strength and toughness. Some materials are strong and tough. Some materials are, this is strong, other part of the strong is weak. It's tough and brittle. Some materials are tough and some materials are brittle. Now, the wood. We are going to apply these three parameters to wood. Because of the microfiber arrangement, wood is strong, elastic and tough. Wood has strength. Wood is strong because of the strong crystalline cellulose chain. Because of the strong crystalline cellulose chains, wood is very strong. It is elastic because of hemicellulose and lignin. It is elastic because of hemicellulose and lignin. It is not very elastic, but it is elastic. If you sit on a wooden desk as against a metal one, you will see some flexibility. That is why we have built up this most of the this one with wooden one. It is somewhat elastic, not very elastic. Maybe some wood is very elastic, and also wood is tough. The major difficult property to achieve is mostly the less brittleness. Wood is tough because of lignin. It acts as cementing material between microfibrils. Lignin acts as cementing material between microfibrils, and therefore it resists the propagation of cracks. Wood is tough because lignin resists the propagation of cracks. Therefore, wood is not brittle. So, wood has a fine combination of strength, elasticity and toughness. That is one of the reasons that wood has become a very popular raw material. So, this is how we explain how the microfiber angle affect the major structural properties. Then there is another one called microfiber angle. Microfiber angle is the angle between microfibrils and the long axis of the wood cells. Microfiber angle is the angle between microfibrils and the long axis of the wood cells. Angle between microfibrils and the long axis of the wood cells, this is called microfibril angle.
If you have A and B, which one has low microfibril angle? AOB. Which one has low microfibril angle? B. Which one is strong? AOB. Which one is strong? B is strong. This is strong. If the microfibril angle is less, then the wood is more strong. Lower the microfibril, lesser the microfibril angle, lower the wood will be, stronger the wood will be. Lower microfibril angle is associated with the strong strength of the wood. In the forest management, what we can, if we can achieve wood with a lower microfibril angle, then we can use that one for construction timber. Now we used the term earlier, lamellae. Cellulose is made up of microfibrils, and also we said the microfibrils are the smaller structural unit, we said earlier. Microfibrils are arranged as lamellae. Lamellae are the sheet of microfibrils with same microfibril angle. Lamellae is a sheet of microfibrils with the same microfibril angle. Sheet of microfibrils with same microfibril angle is called lamellae. So, microfibrils are arranged in lamellae. They are either arranged in S direction or in Z direction. They are either arranged in S direction or Z direction. Microfibrils are sheet of microfibrils, same microfibril angle. They are either arranged in S direction or Z direction. Then we are going to discuss how this microfibril arrangement and lamellae arrangement differs in different cell wall layers. Middle lamella, in the middle lamella, no microfibrils. Middle lamella, no microfibrils. As you know, it is made up of pectin, calcium and magnesium pectate. Mid lamella in the earlier stages, young stem, mid lamella is made up of calcium and magnesium pectate. However, in the later stages, mid lamella is made up of lignin, no cellulose. Mid lamella contains no cellulose, only lignin or pectate, therefore no microfibril arrangement. In the primary wall, microfibril arrangement is random. That means microfibril arrangement is random. In S1 layer, microfibrils are arranged as lamellae. As you can see, S1 layer is given here. Primary wall microfibril, S1 layer microfibrils are arranged 90 degrees. They arrange as lamellae, these lamellae arrange 90 degrees. S2 layer, we said earlier, I told several times, S2 layer is the thickest layer. Microfibril angle is low, which is 10 to 20. Microfibril angle is low, it is 10 to 20. S3 layer, again the microfibril angle is about 90 degrees. Like S1 layer, these also 90 degrees. These are the different cell wall layers and mid lamella and the microfibril layering. Based on this one also you can see which one is the most important layer in terms of wood property, S2 layer, because it is the strongest layer with less microfibril angle. S2 layer is the thickest and it has the lowest microfibril angle. Normally what we measure is the microfibril angle of the S2 layer, because which contributes more to the strength of the timber. This is the random arrangement of microfibrils in primary wall.
in primary wall, this is the random arrangement of microfibril. This is secondary wall. Microfibrils are arranged as lamellae. Lamellae means sheet of microfibrils is same microfibril angle. So, in summary, cell wall is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin. In fact, we did not say about the chemistry little bit. In the cell wall chemistry, wood chemistry, wood is made up of structural polymers and non-structural compounds. There are three structural polymers. Some are carbohydrates. There are two carbohydrates, that is cellulose and hemicellulose. The non-structural compounds are, some are organic compounds, some are inorganic compounds. These organic compounds are called extractives. These extractives give color or the durability to the timber is by extractives. These will not alter the strength of the material. Inorganic compounds are silica, some would contain silica, varicose, you know, some contain silica and several inorganic materials. So, this is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin and also extractives. Wood is made up of microfibrils. Microfibrils have crystalline cellulose coan, outer hemicellulose and lignin. Wood is strong, elastic and tough due to the microfibril structure. And they are arranged in mid-lamella, primary wall, S1, S2 and S3.